Hi everybody, it's Shelly Hoffman with Hard Home Community, and I'm here today with Paige Rocker, which is crazy because Paige is one of our Beeville seniors this year, and I've known Paige since McNamara Elementary School. So first off, congratulations on graduating when you get there. Another week or so, I guess. But the reason I have Paige here is because you and a group of your friends started a Facebook page called Baldwinsville's Grad to Grad 2020. And obviously you're a grad, meaning a senior graduate, but the other grad is people that we kind of forgot about, which you remembered, and that's the fifth grade moving up kids. You know, they're missing that graduation day. So can you tell us a little bit about how you know, first off came up with the idea and, you know, why it was so important to you?
Yeah, definitely. So I'm an assistant teacher at my dance studio in Beeville, River Rhythms. And so I work really closely with a lot of the little girls there. And I knew a lot of them were so bummed out that they were missing such a thing. I know I was talking with my friends about it, and we remembered like how special this time was for us, and like how big of a deal McNamara especially made it, like just so they knew that we were special. And I felt so bad that these kids were missing out on like such a special time for them, because even though all of this is going on, it still should be special. Like, this shouldn't take away that recognition from them. So we, the seniors, have noticed how the community has came together and they've tried to celebrate us the best they can under the circumstances. And we felt bad that we were getting all this recognition and the fifth graders weren't, even though they were celebrating a huge milestone too. So we wanted to try and kind of give some of that attention and just make sure that they knew that they were important and that they deserve recognition at this time.
You know, that's a really sweet idea, because again, my kids are older, which, you know, because you go to school with Jordan and your sister goes to school with Tay. But fifth grade moving up was a big deal. When we were at McNamara, as parents, we were excited for that day. The kids were excited. They're also not getting the chance, I mentioned to you on the other day on the phone, to walk up to Ray. I mean, they're getting lockers. There's a lot of anxiety for some of these kids to go from the elementary school to Ray. And the teachers, the school, they do a great job kind of like getting rid of some of that anxiety, right?
Definitely. Like, I remember when we got to do like the field trip to Ray, and it definitely made me feel a lot better, like be able to like to meet the principals and like see some of the teachers and like to see the middle schoolers and stuff. And it really just helped me feel better about the move in general. So it's a huge milestone for them. Like, obviously graduating high school is like the first milestone, like the big like first step into adulthood. But this is their first step in like being a teenager. So I mean, obviously it's very situations, but it's like just as big as a deal for them as it is for us. And we just felt bad that they were missing out on like so many new experiences. And obviously, yeah, it does cause a lot of anxiety, like at 10. That's a really big deal. That's a huge change. And I can't imagine like if I didn't get to experience that. So we wanted to try and like ease that comfort. And we knew with like talking to the sixth graders that hopefully we could answer questions about Ray, questions about Baker, Durgy, like sports, like how it all works. So that was also part of the program. It's kind of easing that anxiety and trying to answer any questions that like somebody that doesn't have an older sibling or a parent that knows a lot about the school system, like, so we could kind of answer some of those just to make them feel more comfortable.
Well, and that's what I was going to ask you as far as the page goes. I went onto your page and I saw that, you know, there's kind of a questionnaire for the parents to fill out. I'm assuming most fifth graders do not have a Facebook page. So some of them may, but they're probably more like the Instagram or Snapchat if they have anything at all, right? So it's the parents you're reaching out to, correct, for the... And so, like I said, I went over the questions. What's the purpose of some of the questions? Like, what interests and things like that that they have?
So we tried to put in, obviously, like the basic information. At first, we were trying to match seniors from elementary schools to fifth graders from the same elementary school. But then we kind of noticed that a lot of kids that had very, very specific interests to our seniors weren't from the same school. And we kind of wanted to tailor more based on interest, because for like I was talking about before with sports and stuff, we wanted to give kids the opportunity to like talk to a senior who played their sport in high school and like kind of hear how it all works. So the form was really just about like trying to like gauge how similar our fifth graders were to our seniors, to try and pair them up to somebody that they would feel like the most comfortable with and they would have the most in common with, to try and like get the best experience possible.
Yeah. No, and I can see why that would be, because once you're at Ray, the elementary school doesn't really matter anymore. You know, that first week or so, you may connect with the kids that you went to Eldon or McNamara with. You might try and sit with them at the lunch table. But once you're on teams, because, you know, that's a big new change for Ray, is you're now on a team and you're changing classes and the lockers. And that was pretty smart. And it's nice that you guys are flexible and adaptable and meeting the needs. So I'm assuming you're paired up with a fifth grade moving up student.
I am. I'm paired up Charlotte Malak, which is Pam Malak's daughter. Pam has been really helpful with helping us like get the page started. She's the founder of Baldwinsville, helping Baldwinsville. Yeah. So I also had to go out to her for helping us get everything started, because she's really been helpful with helping me run the Facebook page, because I've been trying to figure out how to run a business Facebook. That was definitely a new adventure. So I'm paired up with her. She's one of the dancers at her studio, and I'm so excited to like reach out and have that connection. And I know a lot of my friends that are in the group that we started as like our reps, they're all paired up. We've already seen some people reach out to us and been like, oh, I reached out to my fifth grader, I sent my first card. And I know a lot of people were telling me that on like the Zoom calls in the fifth grade classes this week, they were all talking about how excited they were to hear from the seniors. So it's really like nice to know that even though it's already been going for a week, we're already like making connections, and kids are getting excited about it, and the seniors are getting excited about it, and everybody is just feeling, I think, more relaxed and calm and just like overall better about a situation that wasn't so great to begin with.
Yeah. Well, and I can tell you from experience, because Casey Killian's one of the ones, she's working with me on Adopt a Senior page, which is similar to what you're doing as far as a community member adopting a senior, with you guys adopting it. So I can say that that first week from there, it just kind of grows. So if you feel like there's like a stall or something, people sometimes sit back and watch to see what's happening, and then they jump in, and then they watch for a little bit longer, and then they jump in. So the nice thing is I think you're just going to continuously, as the days and the weeks go by, you're going to get more and more people joining the page, understanding what the page is for, and getting the word out there. And I think it's sweet. The Onondaga County has, you know, the honor is a senior going off to college page. I'm hoping that what you guys are doing gets picked up from other school districts as well, because it is a shame that a lot of us didn't think about the fifth graders who didn't get that last part. Do you remember the, you know, all the outside special, well, we lost the Special Olympics this year, but the Olympics, the fifth grade moving up day, the party, the ceremony, the celebration. You mentioned, you know, the field trip, but what your mom said that you guys also are missing that was a connection to these kids is you used to go back to your elementary school and walk the halls, and that's obviously not happening either.
That's it. That was something we all were really looking forward to. I know me especially, I go back and I help out with the Summer Olympics at McNamara. I have every year, I think, since freshman year. So I always look forward to going back to McNamara and getting to see my old teachers and getting to see all of the kids. And so I was really excited this year for the senior walk to be able to like experience that. I know our district said they were going to try and do it in some way, do it in some form to try and give us a little bit of that. But obviously it won't be the same capacity that has been in years past. But yeah, that was a really special thing that I think a lot of the little ones look forward to. And I know a lot of us do too, because it's really nice just, again, have that connection. So we were hoping this would also kind of not act as a substitute, but try and make up for a little bit of what was lost here.
Yeah, no, I think that's a great idea. If there was a message that you wanted to get out to the community that's watching, obviously you want them to like and share the page so more people are aware of it. Is there anything else the community can do to support you guys and what you're trying to do?
I mean, obviously, like you just said, getting the word out there, I feel like, is the most important thing. I know we're already at over 200 seniors and fifth graders combined, so there's already a lot of people involved. We want to get the majority of the community involved. We just want to know. We just want everybody to know like what we're doing and to try and spread it as much as possible. And it would be great for other districts to pick it up and just give everybody the recognition at this time. I feel like with everything going on, it's so easy to feel upset and it's so easy to feel frustrated, especially at a young age, like at 10. It can be hard to understand why this is going on and why we have to do what we're doing. And just, you know, that you're losing out on something, but you're not really sure why. And I know a lot of the seniors have felt that way too. It's just a good way to try and stay positive during this time, to try and focus on something else besides what's going on. Because yeah. I feel like important for me is to have something to do to where I'm not focusing on what I'm missing out on. I'm instead looking forward to the new things that I've gotten to experience because of this, which I never really thought of until now. And it's like, I'm missing out on a lot, but I've also gained so much from this experience that I never really expected.
Yeah. You know, the one thing that I'm sitting here thinking about as a mom, as I'm listening to you, it's also, you know, I know that you've given back a lot to the community through your dance and different things, and people have helped through churches, camps, youths, different groups. But there are some seniors who maybe they haven't had that chance to know the gratification, the feeling of giving back to somebody else. And this is the perfect opportunity because you don't have to have a special skill set or a talent. You've been through fifth grade. You know what it's like to go to Ray. You remember what it felt like. So to take those feelings and pass them back to somebody who is now having those feelings, that anxiety or that excitement. And even for the fifth graders, just to share the excitement of going to Ray with someone, because they're not getting that bonding experience with their classmates right now either, you know?
And that's such a big time for them too, with like having fun with each other and like socialization and just like being together. I know like a lot of us, like even though we're older, we're struggling with not being able to see each other and like dealing with like social distancing. So at that age, that's so important to be able to make those connections when you're going into such a big change and you don't know if you're gonna see any of your friends again. It's like, we're trying to just make those connections and try and make kids feel more comfortable and like knowing that this is a huge change, but they're gonna be okay. We got through Ray. We got through graduating through a pandemic. Like if we could do this, they can do anything.
Yeah, no, you're absolutely right. So, well, thank you, Paige. Like I said, I'll do my best to share the information and share your Facebook page out there. I think it's a great idea. If I had a fifth grader, I'd be so thankful that somebody's reaching out and, you know, and sharing that support with them, because it's hard as a parent, you know, they're homeschooling and everything else that's involved with, you know, the social distancing. I know there's a lot of appreciation out there for what you guys are doing. So thank you very much.
Thank you. I'm so glad. It's like, well, you know, it's a lot going on right now. We're just glad to be helping ease the tension a little bit.
Absolutely. So, well, just as a little background about yourself, where did you decide to go to college?
So I'm going to Hofstra University. I'm majoring in dance education and I'm minoring in entrepreneurship.
Nice. Very nice. So, and you're helping out at the dance studio, correct? Well, when you can.
When I was. Yeah, definitely. I've been at River Rhythms for about 7 years. I've been assistant teaching for, I think, about 3. I've been subbing since this year. They've really helped me, obviously, realize that this is what I want to do with the rest of my life. I've wanted to work with kids for a really long time, but working at the studio has definitely really helped me realize that, again, this is what I wanted to do and just further ground me in that. And I'm really thankful for that.
Well, we're thankful, because obviously if you weren't at the dance studio and connecting with those young kids and realizing what they were missing, then the page may not have been formed. So like I said, we're, as a community of Baldwinsville, I say it a lot, Paige, it's a very, very much a small community that supports each other. And people are realizing more through COVID-19 that it's always been this way. It's just we've never had to band together quite so much like this. So people like yourself and the other kids in the group, it just shows the love, support, and the community love, I guess, that we have here. So thank you very much again. And you enjoy the rest of this Memorial Day weekend. Hopefully you're getting outside and not doing a ton of schoolwork, but I know they're keeping you seniors busy, right?
I mean, I've been trying to do some of my homework outside because it's just so nice out. Like, I don't want to miss this time. We've been inside for so long, it feels like.
I know, I agree. So, all right. Well, thank you again for coming on the page. And if you haven't liked it yet, make sure you like and share. It's Baldwinsville Grad to Grad 2020. Everybody have a great day. Enjoy the Memorial Day weekend. Bye.
Thank you.